I was taking college classes, and one of my professors used to babysit for a couple. And one day she kept hearing a noise upstairs, and she went upstairs, and there was a little girl that was chained up to a wall in an attic, and she was a Down syndrome. And she said, but that's what the day was. They used to hide them away or institutionalize them instead of letting them be the people that they are, because they were afraid of them. They were different. I was a 19-year-old when Shannon was born. I was very young and did not know about many disabilities at all. And after he was born, I mean, he was 6 months old before we got full definition that he was, that it was definitive that he was Down syndrome, after all of the tests were run on him. And then we started doing a lot of research then. People in today's day and time look, and if something isn't perfect, then they don't want it. Mm-hmm. Well, they just don't realize how perfect a Down syndrome child is.
During the first trimester, they do an alpha-fetoprotein test, or triple test, whatever it's called, and it came back positive, and we just did the level 3 sonogram, and the guy that was doing that, when he was checking everything out, he said everything was in the normal level, so we all went home from there. I was not going to do an amniocentesis, whatever, you know, that thing they stick in your belly. I can't say it right. But I was not going to do that unless it was life and death for my baby.
There's a child, like any child with Down, I mean, they're loving, you know. Never met a stranger, just, you know, if you've been up with kids that were, once she started walking, you could walk in the house and use her best friend. She'd just hug on anybody, love on anybody.
You know, we just always tried to make her have everything she could and do everything she could. I mean, she didn't live a life locked in a closet or locked in a room or being told you can't do this, you can't do that. If she doesn't feel handicapped, then who's to say she is? What gives somebody else the right to say that, you know, she can't do something? Because she can.
I work 15 years at Festival Changes. I do clean up here up. It's not both clean. I do towels, to trash. It's my job to there to clean, to get away, to do much, to do not have to run. Get a towels full, get a break, work hard, break, get it done.
We have some days that are really, really slow. I don't have to go and tell him, Shannon, keep yourself busy. He ties a little towel on the waistband of his pants, and then he starts wiping down all the tiles, moving things around and sweeping and wiping there. It's, you know, he's always looking to keep himself busy. I don't have to really tell him. He's not too much of a person that's just gonna sit around and not do anything.
Just my crazy ear.
A patient with a Down syndrome diagnosis, they have to be treated like anybody else. And although they have certain limitations, IQ, you know, they have limited IQ and limited things that they can do because of their disability. But they're not, they shouldn't be deprived of the rights of a normal person.
They may talk a little different, sound a little bit different. They may move, walk a little bit different. But we all have something.
I swear to God, until Haley had this stroke, she never knew she was handicapped. We didn't raise her as a handicapped child. We didn't let people treat her like a handicapped child. She never knew until she had the stroke. Now she knows, and it's not because of her Down syndrome.
I got the phone call, and my mom was so upset She was like, they don't know what they're doing. I know she's had a stroke, and I know now I should have gone right then based on her reaction, and I didn't because they were acting like it was nothing.
Haley's quite a bit different because not only does she have the Down syndrome, but she does have the stroke, and so we have to address the stroke and we have to address the Down syndrome. And so we would treat Haley differently than we would just specifically a stroke client or just specifically a client that has Down syndrome. A lot of that has to deal with the family dynamics and how much the family's willing to help and how much they're willing to get in there and make her do it. A lot of times whenever a client has a deficit or they have an accident such as a stroke, the family just wants to take care of them and do everything for them. And that's not necessarily the important thing. You have to make the client do it.
Seth does many activities. He does Special Olympics, and we do bocce ball, basketball, bowling, and equestrian. And he also rides at Whispers of Hope, and he's on the Challenge Show team. And then we go to First Baptist Church, and he's involved in all the youth activities and life group. Balancing our activities is sometimes quite hard. A lot of times my husband will go with our older child because he usually coaches with him, and then I'll stay with Seth and do his activities.
My goodies. I got a sick reputation for handling broads. All I need is me a few seconds and more, then it's a wrap. Tell the lady bring my lap, and I ain't coming back, so you can put a car right there. I'm the truth, and I ain't got nothing to prove. And you can ask anybody, cause they seen me do it. Barricades, I run right through them, I'm used to them. Throw all the dirt you want, no deal. Still won't have a pen up in a fabulous room. On her back, picking out a basket of fruit.
I love you, boo.
Yeah, freaking Petey, love you too.
She picks that stuff up. She didn't go to dance school or anything like that. But yeah, she can move.
Haley loves to have fun. You know, if there's dancing music, she's gonna be there to dance. She's no different than anybody else. She's a regular girl, likes to get her nails done and laugh at funny jokes. She tells some of the funniest jokes. If you listen to her, she'll like make you roll on the floor.
Seth, I've been working for him pretty much the whole 3 years that I've been here. He started out with other therapists. He can be very difficult as far as his behavior and everything. So I think sometimes a big male that can be firm with them, we have better outcomes with it.
What do you like to do?
You.
Do you like?
You ask me first.
Do you like to?
What do you? You ask me first.
Okay. What do you like to do?
Get a shake.
Get a shake. It's hard sometimes. It's very, very hard sometimes. Making everything where we're trying to be more positive, we're trying to be more nice and kind in our whole entire family because we have two teenagers. I think our secret is that we have faith in God, and that plays a major role. We have our problems just like everybody else, but we try to communicate with each other and, you know, make sure that we spend quality time together.
Yeah, I like to talk in a reading the Bible, to talk about a cross to done. Christ died on the cross, that's love. He loves us that much. We know that Jesus, God's son, he teaches us and learn to stay out to trouble.
When he prays at night, he prays to see Jesus. When he says his prayers at night, he prays for everyone, and he every day he tells me he can't wait to see Jesus. So his faith has increased our faith.
I got an NFL right there, to Dars, to Troy Aikman, to Dallas Clark, to Carlos Light.
He's always liked sports from the time he was little bitty, mm-hmm, until now as a full-grown man. I guess, ingrained in him being from the family he's from.
I like watching him, doing his part, doing this.
Teach your children to be tolerant and understanding. But they're not any different. They might be a little slower, but we're all the same.
They're kids first. They're kids that have Down syndrome, but they're kids first. They have feelings just like everybody else, and they want to be loved and supported and, you know, included in everything just like everybody else.
It's okay to have somebody that's different working with you, because sometimes, you know, you have to take a little bit of extra time to show him what to do if it's something new, and be patient with that. But, you know, it's okay in the end, because he will do it and he'll be good about it. And the next day, everything is fine again.
Down syndrome people are people. They have and can lead productive lives. They can hold down jobs. It doesn't matter to them how menial the job is. They just enjoy doing something.
There's people there to help you. Don't think that because you have a child that's born with Down syndrome or any kind of handicap that you're gonna not be able to live a normal life. Because like I said, normal's only as normal as you make it.
Trouble.